Hi everyone and welcome back to another episode of Dark Souls 2 PvP live session stuff. Today I'm using the Loyce Greatsword because I feel like using an actual good weapon this time. It's not top tier, but at the edge of it, so I should not use against a opponent that uses like bad weapons, except when he's laggy and the fight doesn't mean anything. So I am using this weapon on a practically Robflin build, under 40% equip load with some armor, 300 physical, 150 elemental, so let's just go. The thing with this is that it has a ton of reach, deals a ton of damage, and has like okay, that was a nice trade for you. This guy tries to trade with katanas. Well, that should work when he would not play against the Loyce Greatsword on a Robflin. I was pretty trade happy there, but well, it works with this weapon, so why not? Basically, the R2 is an amazing reach. The R1 is for people who like to roll around you. The run attack is good for basically, since it's a great sword run attack, it's good for everything. The R1s can you spam pretty often, and the 200 roll attack is great with the reach, but I never like use it since I'm bad, so you should use a lot of the 200 roll attack. This attack is great. Alright, let's continue. Continue to butt wreck. Alright, the purifier. He uses top tier, is that? No, he uses them. Yeah, alright, that's going to be exciting. Alright, Red Iron Trimblade against Loyce Greatsword. Ah, god! Yeah, nice backstab. I'm sloppy as fuck. But that's also always like that since when I'm... he has kind of a strange latency. It's not that it's bad or something, or package loss, it's just... Yeah, that would have been my hit. At least this one. At least I got this combo. Alright. Oh, Jesus. Alright. Yep. GG. GG, nice fight. Yeah, this was the case when we have a good constant connection, but the distance produces a bit of latency, which makes the trades which produces more trades than necessary. Which is on those two weapons not that bad. So, oh, I should also like watch out when I have to switch to the physical Loyce Greatsword that I have instead of the elemental one. I'm on a 30-30 build, which, like, yeah. I should swap to the physical one when someone is there with a high elemental defense, which this guy didn't have. He had like no big armor, I think. Alright. Oh. Hello. This guy looks like a newbie, full lock on and stuff. Uh-huh, trade. Whoops. All like that. All just spam. Yeah. I'm just bad. But you should not trade. Those were 1000 damage in 3 hits. Not bad. But you see how sloppy I play, and Well, I like to be kind of aggressive to be beatable with it. So if I get killed, I still have an excuse. Ha! In general, the R2 of this weapon and the run attacks are great. The R1s... The follow-up R1 locks you in the place in the direction, has no tracking at all, so it's not that great. But in itself, this weapon, pretty solid, pretty good. A fun weapon to play with. I never play with it because I like to have weapons with... Like, when I play with weapons for fun, then I play with either... with real meta weapons, let's say it like that. This weapon is too bad to be considered... too good to be considered a bad weapon. But, oops. But too bad to be considered a real meta weapon and to be, like, super easy to fight with. I didn't want that backstab. So... It's, like, in between that. Since it is half of a straight sword, basically, with the R2 and the roll attack. Half straight sword, half great sword. That was a missed roll animation, if you asked yourself why this looked strange. Alright, I'll space out the R1s, but got hit either way, so... The times when I miss my B button and turning around. Jesus, dude! Alright, he will do a run attack. GG. He could have just rolled, but he wanted the spam and then got irritated when he didn't hit me with a run attack. Like, okay, do your run attack already? Thanks, get fucked. Oh, yeah. The times these days are like when it like goes slowly to the end. This game's PvP. Of course, I will still keep up the content, I guess. And oh well, it's pretty chilled. Pretty chilled. All right, this guy again with not so good latency. So I have to watch out that I don't do many lag trades. I have a high reach advantage over him, so... yeah. Ah! Got it! This is the technique where I also talked in the last episode about unlock. And whoops. Yeah, that was again a bit more laggy trade than I liked it. Yeah. Yeah. 10 out of 10. Alright, let's go red tearstone mode and he will do run attack. Fuck, that should have been a punish by far, but he recovery cancels too. Thank you. Jesus, that should have. Dude! Ah! That sucks! Jesus Christ! His weapon's like the same tier. Basically not meta at all, but also not really bad. Like, you can trade, like, it has basically, the thing with these two weapons is they have a bit slower moveset, but such an insane blunt damage that if you hit people with it, they're basically fucked already. And we have the same shit latency guy again. Thank you. Like, it's so annoying to have such constant shit latency, since he will get the trades and he will basically win it. Yeah, get fucked. I will only spam R2s in this fight. Like, he spams his run attacks with recovery cancels. Annoying. Wouldn't have wondered if that would have hit me, because this guy's connection is shit. And there's another lag trade. Oh god, this fight is bullshit. These fights are bullshit against this guy. And recovery cancelling, because that's so damn skilled. Basically being unpunishable. Like, I cannot outspace him because he lags like shit, but I can also not punish him because he recovery cancels, and for punishing his recovery cancels, I would have to outspace him directly. So, like, this is like super shitty because he does, like, look at that shit. And he has a shit ton of stamina as well. Yeah, of course the lag trade. Like, there's nothing else I can do against him. It's so damn annoying. Jesus Christ. Ah. Now I'm interested in where this guy's from. Oh. Wouldn't wonder if he's from America or something, because, of course, yeah, he is from the United States, which explains why the latency is so shitty, and he uses the weapon that is easier to trade with, because he has more blunt damage, and he has recovery cancels, which make it unpunishable. So, yeah, nothing to do against. There's literally no way how I would be able to win against this shitlord. Well, can't do much, but have to accept it. Have to accept that some people are shitty. Basically, no episode goes by when I don't hate about someone. But oh well, that's part of the game, right? What would our community be if we wouldn't shit-talk each other all the time? yay, someone else! Huah! Alright, let's see. Please, no latency guy, please. He uses the same sword. Our connection is a bit better. Not a lot, but a bit. He uses lottery gauntlets, which is... Yeah, that's how you kill people who are not that latent and are not that cheesy to recovery cancel everything, because this guy in this case didn't know about it. So this is like how you destroy people with a weapon, which leads to you being able to rank up pretty fast with it. Just also as a full lock-on player, if you are that, it's pretty good to just backpedal all the time and spam R2s, because they have good lingering frames to catch people in their rolls and are guaranteed R2-R2 combo if you catch them right, and have a shit ton of reach, so just backpedal all the time and do R2s. It's a pretty safe way. Optional is buffing and or gestures and a great shield. But a great shield, you don't need a great shield since you will two-hand this weapon anyways. This is the real catch R1, just stand. Oh, okay. Whoops. Run attack missed. Oh. That was so shitty. From me. Boop. Lingering frames. Aww. Aww. I wanted that. How about bare hand parries? No? Okay. Chaos Blade, please. Oh my god. Oh, counter damages. Jesus. Can't fuck around too much. Like, one try to bare hand parry, and then you have to finish him. Can't fuck around too much, basically. Alright. Nuffy. Okay. Do it. Bare hand parry. Don't do that. Don't. Just don't. Wow, the people are missing their roll animations. Left and right. Jesus. Yeah, just little tip, always go for the guaranteed, even for the guaranteed combos, even if you run out of stamina. That's basically what I do. Like, guaranteed combos are guaranteed combos. Just like the R2, like if you catch an opponent now, go for it, because he will panic roll out of it. And won't punish you for it if it's not a top tier player. Because the very good players, they actually keep your stamina in mind, and if you catch them in an attack that lets you run out of stamina, they'll just spam away and you will get hit a lot. So only do that against like mediocre players and lower. Alright, the same guy again. Let's see. Power stance straight swords. Or not. Alright. Like what this guy did, if you fight against this weapon, don't roll away straight, because this weapon has the R2, which will most often catch you in rolls if you roll away straight. I can outspace this guy's attacks if he wouldn't just spam away. Like, 477 is not a bad amount at all. Bare hand parry? Bare hand parry? Jeez, bare hand parry? Bare hand parry? Bare hand parry? God damn it! I wanted to actually bait him into attacking, and then it was a trade, because ooh, that guy was pretty shitty. But yeah. Still have to do the yogurt spear. Oh yeah, I hope you all had a great day. And yeah. This weapon's pretty straightforward actually. Like, R2s and run attack and roll attacks. There's not much more to it. Even like, let away the run attacks, just press R2. Get 1000 damage in. Like, why not? Oh, this is this annoying as fuck guy. Okay. Oh my god. Yeah, the crits is not that. Oh, he has a. He looks like he has a ton. Alright, those were like 400 on a pivot. Let's see. 450, I don't know. This probably did more a bit. This guy just spams away his run attacks. A tip from me, for the use of general all weapons, the block button is really useful when two-handing your weapon. Really useful. For once. What I did there is get a run attack, and if you hit the run attack and don't want to follow up immediately because they will just panic roll away and don't get hit, press block and then R2. That's what I just did, and that caught his roll. That little delay from block and R2 caught his roll. Same with turning around. R2, block, turning around, R2, is easier to do than R2, R2. See that? I did the exact same thing, just didn't hit the block button. Generally block to turn around, R1, block, turn around, R1, is better than R1, turn around, R1. It doesn't seem like much of a difference, but I hit block probably more than attack in a fight. It's also good to like bait out their rolls when you go for run attacks. Like if you move around and space around and then block 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 R2 or block block R1. Like just random blocks helps you be far more to have far better movement. Whoa, okay. Why didn't this guy didn't take his guaranteed combo? Okay, never mesh the R2 directly. Should have been a backstep. What I did there was blocking to delay it. Fucking black steel. Get fucked. That was when he speculated for me to panic roll, but with that R2, like I think he did it like an run attack, R2 and R2. That already 100% has used up his stamina, and what I did was just stand there and attack him because he ran out of stamina with that attack. So I was pretty sure to get the attack in, and he tried to recover his bit of stamina while I was panic rolling and then hit my panic roll, but that didn't work because I didn't panic roll. Because I knew he would be out of stamina. Those are like the few mind games you have to keep in mind when fighting against people in this game. Just like, it comes with the feel of the opponent. That's also why I often get hit by people who have like... that R2 was a startup attack. That startup attack... Chaos Blade, huh? What you gonna do with that Chaos Blade? Gonna hit R1 a few times, okay. Alright, outspacing Chaos Blade. Or not. That was not at all necessary that I unlocked my camera there, but it's more fun. It's basically just more fun. You get a guaranteed combo. Because why not, right? Why not? This game's supposed to be fun. Alright, another fight. Jesus. Yeah, but most competitive players just have shit connection with me. And like I said already in some... No, I didn't say it actually, I didn't upload that session where I said it. When I play against actual good players, I always lose almost completely because I'm far too aggressive. Like I said, wow, holy shit, look at this guy teleporting. Yeah, this connection is like super shitty. Look at this shitty connection. That wasn't even the backstep, what the fuck? I can still trade. I will trade with you all day. Yep, and he switches to a faster weapon because his connection is shit and this makes it harder for me to avoid his attacks. Great, isn't it? Yeah, and he can roll, and since he has a shitty connection, my attacks... There he goes, he's pretty skilled. Dagger riposte. What is this? 2014 and wake up hit. Holy sh... Oh, that was a skilled wake up hit. Almost killed me there. I can't even, like, hit him. Yeah, look at this. You are skilled with your shitty ass connection. Jesus Christ. Fucking hell. But what should you do? Oh well. Let's just keep on fighting. This fight, of course, didn't mean anything because a fight with that shitty connection cannot be taken seriously by any means. As well as the fights against the other guy with the red iron twin blade, which are basically both fights that I lost. And I both lost them because of the shitty connection. All other guys which had a shitty connection were just bad, which made me able to win against them, although they had a shitty connection. Alright, it's this guy again. Right, I'm still at the normal. Alright, do you want to spam your run attack again? Thank you. Or not. Do it again. Oh, dagger. Now I have two. Like, what you saw there, I went from... It's so annoying! Jesus! What I want to say, what you saw there is I went from... fucking hell. Dagger repost! Yay! I'm so triggered right now. Do your run attack, oh yeah. Oh, sick parry, bro. I will be reactive. Now I decided that I want to win this fight and am reactive. He will do a run attack, I will outspace it and kill him. Yeah, all that. Parry this piece of crap. Like, he's so annoying with this fucking throwing knives. Jesus. Look at this piece of shit. This piece of garbage. Trade with me and get fucked. I will one spam until... Oh my... Okay, now out of stamina. Jesus Christ, it's like, can't you just take one weapon, one non-meta weapon, and play with it, 1v1, physical only. Instead this guy goes like, okay, now I will take out the throwing knife, and another one, and another one, and another one, say my name, baby. And then he will spam the stagger run attack and R1, and spam parries, and... Dagger repose and his whip that doesn't actually do anything. And wow, Jesus fucking Christ! What I want to say, when he took out the whip, I stayed on the reach, or I went close to him, since all of his whip attacks are very predictable. Like, you can react easily to them. To each single one of them, but like when he switched to the dagger, I took distance again to outspace him, since his dagger is like, he has stone ring on, like we saw on the stagger probably, and his dagger was like more effective on close range. This, he has a shitty connection too, Jesus Christ, people. Okay, I will lose this fight because he's able to leg trade all the time. Because, look at this! You can already notice when it's shitty, when you see his roll. Look at this! Where was this backhop? Fucking hell! Yeah, sick parry, dude. Jesus, look at this. Where are you from, dude? Brazil or China or... And now you want to parry because it's skilled or what? Fuck you, I will lag trade against you. Yeah, sick parry, dude. Do more parries and like look how he's running away. He doesn't do anything. He just lag trades. And parry spams. Even more parry spams. Look at him. What the fuck? Fuck you. Come on, do press parry. What? Look at this. Okay. You know what? I will pivot him in his ass because he's annoying. Yeah, of course not, because he's fucking laggy as shit. Look at this shit, Lord. Jesus, fuck you. My fucking god. What? Oh, I just noticed we are over the time. Thank god. You laggy piece of shit. Alright. We ended. Just how we end pretty much every episode with salt. Except the last one and every other episode, so... this was the Loyce Greatsword episode. I hope you enjoyed it nonetheless, and thank you for watching. Request weapons in the comments below, and I hope to see you all in the next video. Bye bye.